वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द यूनिट नंबर 3, द इलेक्ट्रिकल नेटवर्क पैरामीटर्स एंड पैसिव फिल्टर्स इन टू पोर्ट नेटवर्क. इन द टू पोर्ट नेटवर्क वी विल गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एच पैरामीटर्स और हाइब्रिड पैरामीटर्स. द एच पैरामीटर्स ऑफ द टू पोर्ट नेटवर्क सर्व्स टू रिलेट द वोल्टेज ऑफ द इनपुट पोर्ट V1. हियर इज द वोल्टेज पोर्ट. हियर इज serve to relate the voltage of the input port, and from that here is the input port V1. Input port is the V1, and here is the output port is the I2. Means V1 and I2, these are the two parameters in the hybrid parameter or H parameters. Basically, the H parameters of the two port network serves to relate the voltage of the input port V1 and current of the output port I2 in terms of the current of the input port I1 and the output port I2. So from this figure we have understand about that the basic concept of the hybrid parameter. Means V1, I2, these are the dependent parameter, and I1, V2 is the independent parameters. And in case of the hybrid parameter, it is the combination of the voltage and current. In case of the Z parameter, V1 and V2 is the dependent parameter. In case of the Y parameter, there I1 and I2 are the dependent parameter. But in case of the hybrid parameter, there are the two port network. And in case of the two port network, V1 and I2, means basically we learn about it. Here, in case of the hybrid parameter, the V1 and I2, means here is the I2 and here is the V1, means these are the two parameters. Means V1 and I2, these are the two parameters which is called as the hybrid parameters. Means V1 and I2 is the dependent parameter, and which is the function of I1, V2. Here is the I1 and V2. These are the independent parameter. So we have right now the equation for a hybrid parameter. There is a V1. Here is the V1, which is equal to hybrid parameter H11, here is the H11 into I1 plus here H12, here is the H12 of this parameter V2. Here is the V2. Is the equation behind it V1, which is equal to H11 I1 plus H12 V2, and the next parameter we return I2. These are the dependent parameter, and this parameter will be written I of 2, which is equal to H of 21 into I1 plus H of 22, here is H of 22 into V2. Means these are the equations to find out, and from that equation, here is the equation number 1 and here is the equation number 2. Then from the equation number 1 and 2, we have to be find out the parameter, hybrid parameter, that is H11, H12, H21 and H22. Then how to find out that parameter? Suppose here I1, which is equal to 0, and V2, which is equal to 0. Once the I1, which is equal to 0, is the open circuit parameters. Open circuit parameter, and to find out the H12 and H22 parameter. Means in the two case, in the first case, there is a I1 which is equal to 0. Here is the 0. Means from that case, I1 which is equal to 0 means basically this and this parameter means H11 and H21, the all are 0. Means this is are the all are the 0. Means here is the 0 and here is also 0. Means this two parameter will be 0. Means first we find out this parameter H(1, 2) and H(2, 2). H(2, 2) means here H(1, 2) which is equal to V1 upon V2 means these are the reverse voltage gain, and here is the H(2, 2) which is equal to I2 upon V1 means it is the reverse impedance or reverse impedance and forward impedance. V1 means here reverse admittance will be given H22. In this way we have to be find out the all the four parameters H11, H12, H21 and H22 respectively. So here basically the equation behind it, as per I have given the explanation on the whiteboard, there is a V1 which is equal to H11 I1 plus H12 V2 and I2 which is equal to H21 I1 plus H22 V2. So that equation should be written in the matrix form. In the matrix form it will be given V1 I2 which is equal to in the matrix H11 H12 H21 H22 is the function of I1 V2. So H11 which is equal to V1 upon I1 at I2 which is equal to V2 which is equal to 0 means here is the V2 which is equal to 0. Once the V2 which is equal to 0 means it is the short circuited, means H11 is the short circuit input impedance. Short circuit input impedance means basically here given in the blackboard we have seen there is a V1 which is equal V1 I2 which is H11 I1 plus H12 V2 and I2 which is equal to H21 I1 plus H22 V2. Means here H11 is the short circuit input impedance. Then for V2 which is equal to 0, then H21 and H21 which is equal to I2 upon I1 means I2 upon I1, it is the short circuit forward current gain. Short circuit forward current gain, because current gain is a generally calculated the I2 upon I1. So here is the short circuit forward current gain. Then for the next case what we do, here is I1 which is equal to 0 and V2 is the open circuit. Okay, means I1 which is equal to 0 means it is the open circuit parameter. And once we calculated the open circuit parameter, H12 which is equal to V1 upon V2 means it is open circuit reverse voltage gain. Here is the open circuit reverse voltage gain, because H12 which is equal to V1 upon V2 at I1 which is equal to 0, and V1 upon V2 it is the voltage gain, but it is reverse, because according to the condition the voltage gain or current gain, it is calculated by output voltage to the input voltage. Once it is taken to the reverse, there is an input voltage to the output voltage, then it is the open circuit reverse voltage gain. Next, H22 which is equal to I2 upon V2 means it is open circuited output admittance, not impedance, because V2 upon I2 which is equal to 1 upon Z22 means H22 here is Y(22). The equation is given Y(22) which is equal to 1 upon Z22. Z(22). Means here we have written here Z(22). Z(22). Means here Y(22) which is equal to 1 upon Z(22), it is the output circuit output impedance. In this way we calculated the hybrid parameter, there is a h of 11, there is a h of 12, then h of 21, then h of 22 in this. Then we move forward. Next, there is a condition for symmetry and reciprocity of the h parameter. My dear student, we must know that for the condition for the symmetry means your input voltage gain, your voltage to current ratio at the input side, which is exactly equal to current to voltage ratio, or voltage to current ratio is exactly same for input as well as the output. Hence we calculated that in the h parameter basic equation is given V1 which is equal to H11I1 plus H12V2. The next is the I2 which is equal to H of 21I1 plus H22V2. And from that equation, when I2 which is equal to 0, and once the I2 which is equal to 0 means it is the open circuit. Output is the open circuited. So here I2 which is equal to 0, and once the I2 which is equal to 0, H21I1 plus H22V2. So what we do here, basically Z11 I2 which is equal to 0, therefore here H21I1 plus H22V2, and Z11 which is equal to V1 upon I1. Hence here we have seen here basically Z11 which is equal to V1 upon I1 when I2 which is equal to 0, then H11I1 plus H12V2 upon I1 which is I2 which is equal to 0, and once the I2 which is equal to 0, here V2 upon I1 which is equal to minus H21 upon H22, therefore Z1 which is equal to H11 minus H1221 upon H22. Therefore H11 H22, take the cross multiplication here, Z11 which is equal to H11, because here V1 upon I1 which is equal to, and V1 which is equal to what? H11 I1, means this is directly we have to be substituted here. Here means here V1 which is equal to H11 I1 plus H12V2, here directly substitute, and this will be written directly, you have to be here from here. Means here H11 which is equal to V1 upon I1 which is equal to H11 I1 plus H12V2 upon I1 when I2 which is equal to 0. So for that case what we do, here H11, this I1 should be multiplied here. That's why this I1 and this I1 gets cancelled out. So H12V2 upon I1. So for this case, V2 upon I1, for this case, we have to be calculated. Because I2 which is equal to 0, H21I1 plus H22V2. So take the ratio of V2 upon I1 which is equal to minus H21 upon V2. Right. So we trace out it here. So H21 upon H22. So Z11 which is equal to H11 plus V2 upon I1 means minus H21 upon H22. So take the cross multiplication. After taking the cross multiplication here, H11 H22 minus H12 H21 upon H22 which is equal to, and from that equation H11 H22 minus H12 H21 which is equal to delta H. Basically here is the delta H, means this difference. So delta S should be considered here, म्हणजे डेल्टा एच विच इज इक्वल टू एच वन वन एच टू टू मायनस एच वन टू एच टू वन. सो सिमिलरली द झेड टू टू मीन्स आय वन विच इज इक्वल टू झिरो. इफ आय वन विच इज इक्वल टू झिरो देन व्ही वन अपॉन व्ही टू. व्ही वन अपॉन व्ही टू मीन्स झेड टू टू विच इज इक्वल टू व्ही टू अपॉन आय टू. व्ही टू अपॉन आय टू वेन आय वन विच इज इक्वल टू झिरो अँड व्ही टू अपॉन आय टू इट इज द झेड टू टू राईट. सो आय टू विच इज इक्वल टू फ्रॉम दिस केस आय टू विच इज इक्वल टू एच टू टू व्ही टू एच टू टू व्ही टू. देन हियर आय टू विच इज इक्वल टू एच टू टू व्ही टू देअरफोर झेड टू टू विच इज इक्वल टू ॲक्च्युली एच टू टू विच इज इक्वल टू आय टू अपॉन व्ही टू अँड बट व्ही टू अपॉन आय टू विच इज इक्वल टू व्ही टू अपॉन आय टू विच इज इक्वल टू झेड टू टू देअरफोर विच इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन एच टू टू मीन्स आय टू अपॉन व्ही टू इज दिस इक्वेशन इज रिटन वन्स अगेन व्हॉट आय टोल्ड यू. हियर इज द झेड टू टू झेड टू टू विच इज इक्वल टू झेड मीन्स व्ही टू अपॉन आय टू. हियर इज द व्ही टू अपॉन आय टू अँड v2 upon i2. The same equation we have written which is equal to 1 upon i2 upon v2 i2 upon v2 but here i2 upon v2 but from this case I2 upon V2 which is equal to H22 therefore I2 upon V2 this equation which is equal to H22 therefore this equation is written 1 upon H22 here is the H22 H22 means Z22 which is equal to here Z of 22 this Z of 22 which is equal to H of 22. So here Z22 which is equal to 1 upon H22 therefore Z11 which is equal to Z22 therefore Z11 which is equal to Z22 and Z22 which is equal to 1 upon H22. For symmetric network Z11 which is equal to Z22 and Z11 which is equal to V1 upon I1 V1 upon I1 means here 1 upon H22 1 upon H22 and here Z22 Z22 which is equal to V2 upon I2 V2 upon I2 and V2 upon I2 is nothing but delta H upon H22 the same expression we have written here. Therefore, delta H which is equal to 1. Delta H which is equal to 1. Therefore, this equation is written H11, H22 minus H12, H21 which is equal to 1. Means in this way, we have find out the condition for symmetry in the hybrid parameters. The next, a network is said to be reciprocal if the ratio of the excitation at the one port to the response at the other port is the same if the excitation and responses are interchanged. What happens in case of your input voltage ratio and output voltage ratio should be same or its impedance should be same, then it is called as the input impedance which is equal to output impedance both are same. Then it is called as the condition for symmetry. In case of the condition for reciprocity means your input voltage, output current, output voltage, input current, that both the ratio should be same, which is called as the condition for reciprocity. What happens, see here, once your output voltage V2 which is equal to 0, then it is acting as the short circuited. And once it is the short circuited, V1 which is equal to Vs, V2 which is equal to 0, and I2 dash which is equal to minus I2. Then if the V2 which is equal to 0, then that parameter means for this case here, in case of the hybrid parameter V1 I2, and V1 I2 which is equal to I1 V2, is here I(1) into H(1,1) H(1,1) plus here plus sign, there is a here is the V2, and from that equation again I1 H(2,1) plus H(2,2) into V2, that equation. And once V2 which is equal to 0 means only we have to be find out the parameter H11 and H21. So here for this case, when V2 which is equal to 0, then Vs which is equal to H11, here H11 I1, and here minus I2 dash which is equal to H21 I1. So based upon that, the Vs upon I2 which is equal to minus H11 upon I1, because this I1 gets cancelled out. And in case of the next, there is a your input port is acting as the open circuited, and V2 Vs at the opposite side it will be acting, therefore V1 which is equal to 0 and V2 which is equal to Vs and I1 which is equal to minus I1. So in this way, here 0 will be substitute H11 I1 plus H12 Vs. So H12 Vs which is equal to minus H11 I1 which is equal to H11 I1 dash. So Vs upon I1 dash we have to be calculated. Your Vs is H11 I1 upon H12 V2, means I1 dash. Here is the I1 dash which is equal to H11 I1. So here H11 upon H11 I1 which is equal to H11 I1 dash, therefore H11 which is equal to Vs, there Vs upon I1 which is equal to H11 upon H12, and both should be same. That's why here minus H11 upon H21 which is equal to H11 upon H22. So here is the H11 and here is also H11 gets cancelled, and only the term will be remaining H21 which is equal to H12, but here minus sign, therefore H21 which is equal to minus H12. So in this way we prove that the condition for reciprocity for the hybrid parameter. So next, the synopsis for all parameters, parameters for Z parameter, Y parameter, T, T dash, H parameter, in this way. The condition for reciprocity and condition for symmetry. In case of important parameter is that basically Z parameter, Y parameter, transmission parameter, the inverse transmission parameter, hybrid parameter, inverse hybrid parameter. So for that all the cases, there is a condition for reciprocity. Z12, which is equal to Z21, is the condition for reciprocity. And here the condition for symmetry is that Z11, which is equal to Z22. Then Y12, which is equal to Y21, is the condition for reciprocity for the Y parameter. And Y11, which is equal to Y22, it is the condition for symmetry. The same case, there is a transmission parameter, hybrid parameter, etc. But to find the Z parameter of the two port network, apply the KVL law. To find the Y parameter, to apply the KCL law. Here is to apply the KVL law. For a hybrid parameter, you apply KVL as well as the KCL to give the given network. You convert the equation into the standard form of the Z parameters or Y parameters respectively, and then rearrange the equation to get the standard form of the H parameters and ABCD parameters. I hope that all of you understand. For the hybrid parameter, its condition for symmetry, condition for the reciprocity. If any doubts, any query, please write on my comment page. Please subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon. Thank you. Have a nice day.